Well, all right, here we are once again, and you know what day it is. You know who I am. I'm Pastor Bobby D. Hamilton, and this is Move Monday. Oh, yes, it is. This is a day that we set aside to say that we are going to begin this week by moving our bodies, by getting our heart rate up, by reducing our caloric intake, by simply doing some exercise, by simply allowing ourselves to ambulate. I know for many of you, you had a long four-day weekend and you enjoyed yourself and you ate a lot and you traveled and you had family functions and family affairs and you snoozed and you slept and you went and did a little shopping. And I understand. I heard from some of you. Some of you went to Colorado. I heard from some of you. Some of you even went overseas. I heard from some of you. Some of you traveled, went to see family and friends. And I heard from many of you. Many of you barbecued. And so you were doing some things this past weekend. And today I know you just want to just rest. But I came to say it's Move Monday. As you can see, I finished my sunrise run. I ran my 6 this morning, and I thank God for every one of them. And you know I'm all sweaty and all that, but that's just the way it is. And so I want to just remind you this morning. I've heard from many of you, and you told me about the bicycles you received, and you told me about the yoga mat you got, and you told me about have you joined a walking club, and you've told me how some of you are considering going back to your gym because now it is COVID ready, and you've told me a whole lot of things, but some of you haven't told me anything. Some of you have not said a word because you have not been moving. And so I want to encourage you today. I'm going to encourage the families, the Robinson families. I'm going to encourage you to simply move. The Washington family, I'm going to encourage you today to move. The McGaskey family, I'm going to encourage you to get up and just get going and just move. The Prejean family, get up and move. The St. Julian family, I'm going to ask you to simply get up and move. The Winfrey family, I'm going to ask you also to get up and you know what to do, move. The Joyner family, I'm going to ask you, the Joyner family, to get up and move. There is no excuse. There is no exception. Even if you have physical therapy today, that qualifies as a move. Whatever you need to do, purpose in your heart today that you are going to sweat today. You're going to put in some sweat equity and you're going to move today. I don't know what you're going to do. I don't know how you're going to do it. I don't even know how long you're going to do it. I'm just concerned that you do it. Oh, today is a great, great Move Monday. I know you're ready to do it. Now, you know, yesterday there was a whole lot of moving going on at Friendship Church. You know, yesterday was Resurrection Sunday. And I know if you go online, you can certainly see the message that I preached yesterday that was just talking about Mary, don't you weep. I know it's a different title for a great Resurrection Sunday, but the premise of that text out of John 20, 11 through 18, dealt with this woman who, as I said, she was weeping. She was weeping on Resurrection Sunday because she got some things she wasn't able to connect the dots. And I'm saying that for many of us, for many online, that's the way you are. You've been weeping, you've been groaning, you've been mourning, you've been hurting for a mighty, mighty long time. And here's a couple of things that stood out to me that I was just kind of marinating in my mind as I was running this morning. One thing is simply this, is that she went back to where she used to be. She went back to an old place, and yet God was doing a new thing. She went back to the tomb, but that's where God was. Now, God has been resurrected and he's moved, and yet she was still hanging around at the tomb. And so that's the question I beg for you this morning. Are you still hanging around where God used to work? Or are you open to a new thing? Are you still stuck in the old thing? I remember when, I remember how, I remember the good old days. Well, these can be better days if you let God do a new thing. So many times we're trying to resurrect the old things, the old relationships and the old way of doing things, the old paradigm for living, and yet God wants to do a new thing. Are you still hanging out in the old thing? God wants to move you to a brand new thing. And then there's also something else that marinates in my mind. The very fact of the Jesus she was looking for. Many of us have got the wrong Jesus. In her mind, she had a dead Jesus. And in many people today, the Jesus they have is not the biblical Jesus. It's a cultural Jesus. It's a hearsay Jesus. It's a they say Jesus. But it's not an I know so Jesus. It's not rooted and grounded in the word of God. Which Jesus do you have? Do you have Jesus who just makes bonbons and kisses babies? Or do you have a Jesus who's God of the universe, God of the world, created everything? Which Jesus do you have? That's a very valid question today, isn't it? So I want to encourage you today that Mary, Mr. Mary, Miss Mary, don't you weep. It doesn't mean that in fact we don't have weeping moments and weeping months and weeping years, because you know that we do. But God is able. God is able to dry our weeping eyes. God is able to give us comfort in the midst of chaos. God is able to allow us to move beyond the misery we're in right now. That's the power of God. That's the hope we have in Jesus Christ. The Bible says if our hope is only in this life, then we're most miserable people. But we've got a hope beyond this life that we can also live hopeful and productive in this life. This is for many people. Resurrection Sunday, Easter is over. They're going back to living the normal, usual life. The resurrection isn't about living a normal, usual life. It is about the very fact we can now live abundantly. We can live above. We're able to triumph in the midst of tragedy. Tragedy. And so today I want to encourage your heart. Go back on YouTube. Go look at the message. Play it. Download it. Take notes. Write it down. Emblazon it on your heart. That today you may have a mindset that says, Mary, Mr. Mary, Miss Mary, Cousin Mary, I won't weep, not because I'm so great, not because I'm bulletproof, but because God rose. God in the flesh, in the person of Jesus Christ. Now I know you're going to write me back. You're going to hit me up. You're going to call me because I just said God in the flesh. And I understand that right now has caused great contrition for many of you quasi-theologians. But I'm ready to talk about it. You want to talk about Christ, the biblical Jesus? I'm more amped, ready, and I'm situated, and I'm rooted in ground in the word of God. So if you want to come that way, let's reason together. Let's talk about it. But today is Move Monday, and you get up and you move. Move your family. Move your mind, move your grandkids. Go move your great grandkids. Move your car. So you move your car so you can move around where it used to be. Oh, I thank God for you. Look forward to seeing you on Wednesday night at Friendship, a place to begin again. Whew, what a day.